Thank you. Good evening. Our opening song is Lord of All Hopefulness. Please stand.
Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You are sent to heal a contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf will be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag, then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes comes into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes also comes in, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, "Sit here, please," while you say to the poor one, "Stand there or sit at my feet." Have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters. Did not God choose those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, into the district of the Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd, put his finger into the man's ears, and spitting touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, be opened. And immediately the man's ears were opened. His speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord.
Today's Gospel from St. Mark provides each of us a very powerful lesson from our divine teacher, a lesson about authentic Christian living, the communion of the church, and what it means to be an instrument of God's grace. When Jesus is returning to the Sea of Galilee after his long journey from the north, he is met by some people who, as the Gospel states, brought him a deaf man who had a speech impediment. This act of charity and love clearly and simply demonstrates how it is through the compassion, the trust, and the mediation of other people that we are brought into that saving presence of our divine physician, Jesus Christ, where we experience his healing mercy and transforming power. The people in the Gospel beg Jesus to lay his hand on the deaf man. No fewer than 9 times do we hear of people imploring Jesus in this way so as to gain the assistance of the Lord for the sick, for the possessed, and for the afflicted. Therefore, by bringing this needy, afflicted man to Jesus and interceding for him from the depths of their hearts, these believers of Jesus in the Gospel are acting in a manner that prefigures the revivifying power of the Holy Spirit sent out on the church at Pentecost. Do we mirror these believers in today's Gospel? Do we mirror them through the way in which we bring others in need to Jesus Christ? Through our prayers? By daily living the Gospel? Or by literally inviting to the Holy Sacrifice of Mass those who have fallen away from the practice of their faith? The way Jesus responds helps us to understand how the Lord draws us into a deeper, more intimate relationship with him, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. First of all, Jesus took the deaf man off by himself, away from the crowd. It is in our own prayerful solitude, the quiet time with Jesus, where we give Christ our full attention, secluded from all the distractions, diversions, and seductions of the world, that we can experience his tender mercy and healing love. That's why there is silence within the Holy Sacrifice of Mass, so that we can spend time in solitude with the Lord. Because how much of our life is just filled up with us doing all the talking? Do we ever sit and receive from the Lord? Or are we just doing all the talking? Does this sound reminiscent of the sacrament of reconciliation, where we encounter Jesus Christ in a confessional and confront our sinfulness, seeking the forgiveness and compassion found in the Sacred Heart of Jesus? For Jesus is never content simply to fix the problem others put before him. His miracles are a way of drawing those in need into an intimate encounter with him, into that relationship that can be lifelong. However, that intimacy is impossible on our part if we remain caught up in the clamor of the crowd, of the world, deceiving ourselves into thinking that we have no need of silent moments to encounter the mercy of Christ. There is a pronounced sacramental dimension to this healing in the Gospel. Jesus puts his fingers in this man's ear, He touches the man's tongue. He looks to heaven so as to indicate how God the Father is the source of his healing power. Then he utters a groan and healing word, Ephatha, be open. In other words, through this miraculous healing of this deaf man in the gospel, Jesus Christ calls into play everything that is significant about human existence, especially confidence in our relationship with God our Father, so as to perfect in us what may be defective in our humanity, and doing it in a way that unites us more intimately to him. The saving dynamic continues in the sacramental life of Holy Mother Church that uses visible created things, the spoken word, and the responsiveness of the human senses to mediate the gifts of God's grace. Water is used in baptism, sacred chrism, the blessed oil used in holy orders and in confirmation, blessed oil that is used for anointing of the sick and a laying on of the hands, the bread and wine which is consecrated through the epiclesis of the Holy Spirit to become the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ in the Holy Eucharist. Moreover, Jesus enjoined these people to strictly tell no one. However, what about our Christian obligation to evangelize? All those times that we've experienced the healing presence of Christ, do we want to hold that in to ourselves, or do we want to tell other people about it so that they can experience the divine mercy of God? Christ's words reveal that true, authentic, and sincere evangelization must proclaim the whole Jesus Christ and the full truth of the kingdom of God, not just to pick and choose what we want to hear and teach. We recall today's first reading from the prophet Isaiah, where we heard the prophet's poetic vision, a vision that presents a world redeemed by God's saving power. What the Old Testament prophet communicates through poetry, Jesus Christ does through his miraculous healings and actions. Jesus Christ is not merely a miracle worker who, as the gospel tells us, makes the deaf hear and the mute speak. He is the Son of God who has come to save us from sin and death. St. Augustine, the great doctor of the church, once said this of miracles, and I quote, "Miracles are not contrary to nature, but only contrary to what we know about nature," end quote. Only when we each turn our lives over to his gentle guidance in meditative silence, in the presence of Holy Mother Church and her sacraments, and with the holy fervor of a missionary, can we understand and proclaim what the gospel states. He has done all things well. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and came to heaven. For our salvation, sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus Christ has done all things well. How confident and joyful are our prayers for others when we hear these consoling words in praise of the one who makes the deaf hear and the dumb speak.
That God's salvation may reach to the ends of the earth through the ministry of the church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the actions of all those who govern and legislate will imitate the Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation on Labor Day, that our work will be directed towards God's glory, and that the unemployed will obtain suitable work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to terrorism and for the conversion of all those who are given to violence and hatred, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of those in the military and for our police officers, firefighters, and all our first responders, may they be protected by the intercession of St. Michael the Archangel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be comforted and healed, and that those who have died may share the joys of heaven. We pray especially for Angeline Cianci, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for Dorothy Lewis, who died this past week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pause now and add our own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, you have opened our hearts to the Holy Gospel. You have opened our lips to proclaim it. Receive the prayers of believers baptized in the saving grace of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself. That the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for God, the living God.
Our communion song is On Eagle's Wings.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Mass is in. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
I have two announcements. Next week there is a second collection. It is for the people in Haiti who are suffering from the earthquake and the flooding. So if you could be generous, we thank you for the generosity that you'll show to the people in Haiti. You can put your donations in an envelope and mark it Haiti donation, earthquake donation, and I may have two baskets back there next week instead of one, but it'll be clearly marked. So you can, whatever you would like to give would be greatly appreciated to help the people in Haiti suffering. And secondly, this coming week on Thursday and Friday, there will be no daily mass. On Thursday or Friday, I will be out of town at seminars. So no daily mass on Thursday and Friday.
Our closing song is America the Beautiful.